Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très content d'être ici aujourd'hui, accompagné par notre ministre de la Santé, Jean-Yves Duclos. Our focus continues on keeping Canadians safe, so I have a few updates for you here today. First of all, on treatments. On therapeutics, Monday, Health Canada approved the antiviral Paxlovid. It's an important new tool in our toolkit that will protect against severe outcomes, hospitalization, and death. We have a contract for 1 million courses of treatment. We've received our first shipment, and distribution to provinces and territories are underway. It's important to remember that this will be a powerful tool to continue to keep people from getting extremely sick, but it needs to be used right, and it's not a replacement for getting vaccinated, for wearing masks, for staying safe, for keeping your distance, for doing all the things that need to keep us safe from the beginning. It's just an extra layer of tools that we can use as we move forward in through this pandemic. Sur les vaccins et les tests rapides, on a maintenant suffisamment de doses pour que tout le monde puisse se faire vacciner, incluant avec des doses de rappel. Donc, il n'y a plus aucune excuse. Les gens doivent se faire vacciner. C'est comme ça qu'on va passer à travers. Et je vous le rappelle encore une fois, il n'y a aucune gêne d'aller chercher votre première dose. Je peux vous dire que l'infirmier, l'infirmière qui est là pour vous injecter avec votre première dose va être bien plus content de pouvoir vous donner votre première dose, même aujourd'hui, en janvier 2022, que s'il devait être en train de vous traiter dans les soins intensifs. Please remember, we have enough doses for everyone to get vaccinated, to get their booster shots, so go do it. No matter how you may feel that you're late, better late than never. It's never too late to do the right thing. And the health worker who will be helping you get vaccinated would much rather be giving you a vaccine than intubating you in the ICU. So please keep doing what is right. At the same time, we know as we get back to school, as kids are re-engaging, parents are worried about the health of their kids. Therefore, get them vaccinated. The vaccination rate for kids 5 to 12 is too low in Canada, which means not only are kids more vulnerable, but all of society, whether it's teachers, whether it's grandparents, whether it's frontline health workers risking getting overwhelmed when those people start to get sick, we need to do what's right. We need to continue to do the right thing. That means getting our kids vaccinated. It is safe and effective and the right way to get through this pandemic. Another tool, obviously, is rapid tests, which are extremely important during this wave of Omicron. We are purchasing hundreds of millions of rapid tests and sending them to provinces and territories for distribution to Canadians. Getting tested regularly is an important part of how we're going to stay safe. But again, it's no replacement for getting vaccinated, for getting your booster shots, for getting our kids vaccinated. So let's keep doing that. The hardship of this pandemic is felt by small businesses, by workers, by folks across the country in our economy. That's why we're continuing to step up. We made a promise in the beginning of the pandemic to have people's backs, and we have. There are direct income supports for people who lose their jobs or are laid off, but there are also a wage subsidy for businesses to be able to keep people on the payroll so that we can come roaring back quickly when this current wave is done, keep people tied to their job. These are the kinds of tools that we have that work best. So the wage subsidy, the rent subsidy, the supports we have for people are there to be used. They will be there for all hard hit businesses through this wave. Please make use of them. The federal government is there to help. Mais on sait très bien aussi qu'avec tout ce qu'on est en train de faire au Canada, l'Omicron en est un exemple, cette pandémie ne finit pas nulle part avant qu'elle soit finie partout. Ça veut dire que nous devons continuer nos efforts à l'international pour assurer de l'accès aux vaccins à travers le monde, accès aux appuis médicaux et aux ressources nécessaires. C'est pour ça que, plus tôt aujourd'hui, le ministre Saint-Jean a souligné le 1 milliard de doses livrées par COVAX aux pays à travers le monde. Le Canada va avoir donné au moins 200 millions de doses avant la fin 2022. Canada is and has been, from the very beginning, one of the top donors, including global vaccine donors, and has played a leading role within COVAX and the ACT Accelerator and various mechanisms to make sure we are getting vaccines out to the world and supports to be able to get those vaccines into arms around the world. We're also moving forward on specific supports to develop access to vaccines, including, for example, $15 million to South Africa to develop vaccine manufacturing. We will continue to step up, but we also know that other countries must do the same. We'll continue to work with our partners and friends around the world to encourage people to do that. Speaking of international issues, before I finish today, I do want to touch on the situation in Ukraine. Yesterday, I spoke with ministers and the chief of defense staff and a range of officials on an update and a strategy session around Ukraine. Minister Joly joined the call from Ukraine, where she met with President Zelensky and other top officials and reiterated Canada's steadfast support for the people of Ukraine. We are there as friends and allies. We have a military mission there, Operation Unifier, and Minister Anand has been talking about that. We are there to support and train the Ukrainian troops. And we're working with our international partners and colleagues to make it very, very clear that Russian aggression and further incursion into Ukraine is absolutely unacceptable. We are standing there with diplomatic responses, with sanctions, with a full press on the international stage to ensure that Russia respects the people of Ukraine, respects their choice to choose their governments and their direction. We will always be there for the people of Ukraine, and Canada will continue to stand with our allies in defending our friends in Ukraine. Avec le temps froid, avec les tempêtes de neige, avec des journées sombres et courtes, je sais que c'est des moments difficiles pour les gens à travers le pays. On est en train de sortir d'une grosse tempête de neige en Ontario et au Québec. Et je comprends à quel point les gens sont épuisés. Ça a été deux années extrêmement difficiles et ça continue. On est inquiet pour notre santé, la santé de nos proches, notre économie, nos systèmes de santé. Il y a beaucoup d'anxiété qui pèse sur énormément de gens. Et c'est pour ça que je souligne à quel point c'est important de continuer d'être là les uns pour les autres, d'aider ses voisins, de faire les bonnes choses pour se protéger, mais aussi de veiller les uns sur les autres au niveau de la santé mentale. On a énormément de situations de crise dans lesquelles les gens sont en train de vivre et nous devons être là les uns pour les autres. C'est pour ça que nous avons lancé récemment l'application Mieux-être pour aider les gens à trouver des soutiens en santé mentale. We've recently launched the new Pocket Well app that I encourage you all to download onto your phone. It is an extra tool that the government of Canada has put together to help people access resources for mental health and wellness, to help people be there for each other, and to make sure that people know that we're going to get through this by leaning on each other and by supporting each other. It's what Canadians always do when we're at our best, and the difficulty of this pandemic has brought out the best of Canadians as we continue to step up for each other. So please, be thoughtful, be engaged, be supportive, listen to people, know that young people are facing real challenges around mental health. The elderly, again, are facing isolation and challenges. And we're all in a time of stress and anxiety. The more we can be there for each other, the better off we'll be as we make it through this.